And we got a practice from Practicode. This is actually a family practice internal medicine case, and I thought we'd work through it and code it. It's not very difficult to code, but it'll give you an idea of what you will see in Practicode. Okay, so all the information that is related to a person has been redacted. So this is actually a real encounter, but of course Johnny Smith is a made-up name, and you know, Dr. John. So we have Mr. Johnny Smith. That this is exactly how it would come to you if you were coding often, is, you know, you'd have a date of birth and you'd have a date of service, and you want to confirm your date of service. This is Medicare when you're coding. Sometimes that makes a big difference in what you're looking for, and it really depends what type of coding you're doing as well. You know, if you're doing HCC coding, you look at this case differently than if you're doing for a physician, just a regular physician coding. Now we're going to do it in ICD-10, so we're not paying attention to the E&M, which is a you know, part CPT. We're going to just pull out the information for diagnoses. So this is a chief complaint, is what the CC stands for. It's a follow-up on hypertension and cholesterol. Patient also needs medications refilled and lab work. So we already know kind of what's going on with this patient. We know he has existing diagnoses of hypertension and cholesterol, but he didn't tell us what type of cholesterol he has, did he? Okay, so the HPI is, patient is a 69-year-old male who presents today for his regular scheduled BP check. Since the last visit, status, he has overall felt well with no notable interim problems. He remains on hydrochlorothiazide oral tablet 25 milligrams and Toprol XL oral tablet sustained release 24-hour 25 milligrams for blood pressure control. Okay, and hydrochlorothiazide is also called HCTZ because some people don't like to say hydrochlorothiazide. I particularly think it's fun to say. It's one of those words I can say. But
and you're kind of weird. Yeah,
I'm weird that way. I can also spell it. You know, I can't spell the word beautiful, but I can spell hydrochlorothiazide. This is actually a water pill, which would be a support to a blood pressure pill. Okay, so he has no additional problems with which requires addressing at this time. Okay, so now we're still working with two diagnoses, due for lab work, leaving the state for 4 months. He's probably a snowbirder. He's going to go down south. Says BP at home usually is 120 over 70. Let's fix that. So, in other words, he's been asked to keep track of his blood pressure, and it's, you know, instead of doing a range, it's running pretty good there. Okay, so now we're getting into the review of systems. And this is all information that's very important when you have to do your E&M leveling. We're not doing it, so E&M, we are doing it for the diagnoses. So we're going to pull out any information that supports that he has a problem with his blood pressure, he has a cholesterol problem. So constitutional, he denies fatigue, fever, chills, body aches, weight loss, weight gain, and loss of appetite. So in other words, he denies all of these things. Okay, eyes, denies. Discharge from eye discomfort, double vision, impaired vision, changes in vision. And if you notice, these are all things that if a person was having problems with their blood pressure, could be affected. So the HENT, it says CHPI. So in other words, he's saying everything that you need for this, it's in the HPI. Same thing here. Okay, but cardiovascular, denies chest pain, irregular heartbeats, rapid heart rate, this, I call it syncope, which means he's fainting, dyspnea on exertion, lower extremity edema. So he denies any of that. So then the respiratory is our next thing to look at. He denies. He's not having shortness of breath, wheezing, or cough. Gastrointestinal, when he says go look at the HPI. So then we get into all these other body systems that he's saying, go look at the HPI, go look at the HPI. In other words, they're saying they're not they're not personal.
Everybody's reminding me that it's actually history of present
history
illness.
History of present illness, excuse me. Yeah, personal health. What did I say? Health, personal. Yeah, history of present illness. Sorry. It's personal health information. It's that stuff of what's going on with the patient. Okay, so and often you'll see the doctors do this a lot. They're not going to fill this all again. They're just going to go see the HPI. It's in there. But see, actually, did he talk about the endocrine system in the HPI? No, it's not even mentioned. He's saying, you know, go look at the HPI. So in other words, we have no information there. Now we have his weight, and it's 211. 6 ounces. Now, a lot of times they'll just give the BMI because instead of saying somebody is obese, they'll just say BMI is, you know, height, he's 6 something, blood pressure 141 over 97 sitting. Now, that's an elevated blood pressure, but that's not for us to determine, you know, just because we know that. Because he's saying, well, at home, this is what I run, but it doesn't matter. Today, and he could have white coat syndrome, you know, it goes up when you go see the doctor, and his O2 stats are 95. Okay, so when you see this, like, oh, yeah, he's got elevated blood pressure, but that's not for you. Like I said, it's determined. So now we get into the physical exam, and this seems to be kind of repetitive, but this is what the doctor sees, okay? So constitutional, he appears well-nourished, well-developed, alert, and in no acute distress. His eyes, conjunctiva, which we just told you what that was, normal. Sclera, white, that's the white of the eye. Pupils and irises, their pupils are equal, round, and reactive to light, and accommodation bilaterally. Respiratory effort, breathing, unlabored. Auscultation of the lungs, normal breath sounds throughout, so we're all doing good there. Cardiovascular, the heart, auscultation of the heart, regular. Auscultation just means he listens. He auscultates listening. Regular rate and rhythm, no murmurs, gallops, or rubs. Peripheral vascular system, carotid arteries, normal pulses, bilateral, no bruits present. And these are all types of sounds that they would hear, you know. Extremities, no cyanosis, clubbing or edema, normal capillary refill, distal hair distribution normal. When you get to be older, they talk about the hair on your extremities more because it indicates stuff. But, you know, this is all stuff that if he was having problems with his heart and it was getting exacerbated or moving into another disease process, these would indicate that. Abdominal, soft, non-tender assessment. Now, assessment is just another word for it. This is my diagnosis. Benign essential hypertension. I have no idea why these are there. Overall stable with satisfactory control. Okay? So he's got benign hypertension. Hypercholesterolemia. So there's his cholesterol. Now, that's his diagnosis. What's he going to do about it? He's going to order a lipid panel and a CMP medications. He's going to keep him on the hydrochlorothiazide and the prevastin. Prevastin is actually a blood pressure or a cholesterol medication, and this is the generic name for whatever that was, Toprol, that he was taking. So disposition, he wants him to return to the clinic in 6 months, and he has electrically signed it, and there's all kinds of things you have to know about the electronic signature. But we can now support by the medications that he's on, that he's benign essential hypertension, and he's got hypercholesterolemia, which is pure cholesterol. The same thing. So when we go to code this, I-10 is essential primary hypertension. Now, if you are a coder, you would know that in ICD-9, essential hypertension is 401.9, but benign hypertension is 401.0, and we have a diagnosis of benign. So we would use in ICD-9 401.0, but there's something interesting here, and I'm going to show you a document camera snapshot of the ICD-10 manual. But first, let's talk about the pure hypercholesterolemia, which is E78.3, because this is actually in the endocrine system, okay? Your cholesterol and all that stuff is all being done by the endocrine system. Okay, so let's look real quick. Let's see if I can get this to come up. I-10. Ah, there we go. Aren't I good? So, look, you got here. Diseases of the circulatory system, just like in ICD-9, you have your range. It starts with I-10 and goes to I-21.02. Okay? We're in hypertensive diseases, and it's saying, use additional code for these codes, I-10 through I-15, to identify. And then it's telling you, pay attention. You're going to be able to, if it stated that that guy smokes, you would have been able to use this code with your hypertension. Now, essential primary hypertension, I-10. But where's the benign? And you look down here, it's like, oh my gosh, it's not there. Did they just get rid of benign? But then, look right here, it includes high blood pressure, hypertension, and look, benign. So, unlike ICD-9, I-10 covers all of these other different types of hypertension. Malignant was a different code. It was, you know, essential was 401.9. This was 401.0. Malignant was, I think, 401.1 or 2. I can't remember because malignant you didn't code very much. But anyway, they're all included in I-10. So you only have to code one code that encompasses all of those codes that you did before. Then here we've got an excludes. Now, if you have hypertension because of a complication in pregnancy, these are the codes you need to go look at. If you have these types of hypertension, they're telling you, look, go, you know, yep, you're in the right section. You just need to move over. We're going to jump to I-60, okay? And it is, I see someone saying, but I thought it was more specific. It actually is more specific because look down here. You've got hypertensive heart with heart failure, hypertensive heart without heart failure. Now, you get into the hypertensive chronic kidney diseases, it's much more specific. Now, of course, your hypertension is not bilateral, so you have no laterality here.
Do you want to check the answers there just to make sure that you didn't say something backwards? I'm not sure what they were saying there when they said malignant equals
401.0. 401.0. O is malignant, HTN, 401.1 is benign. Thank you, Nancy. You're right. Yeah, 401.1 is benign, and 401.9 is essential, and 401.0 is malignant. Very good. Thanks, Nancy. Yeah, that's what I get for trying to do these off the top of my head. I've been doing ICD-10 so long, I'm forgetting ICD-9, those ones that I've got memorized. But I can tell you that this is probably the very first ICD-10 code that you'll memorize because you'll use it a lot. And hypertension is one of those things you just do again and again and again. And it's so easy to remember, I-10. Very good. We got really savvy people here tonight.
A good one from Beth, no coding out of the mind index.
Oh, yeah, there you go. Yeah, you get dinged for that, Beth, if you code from the mind.
Beth just dinged you.
She did. She dinged me good.
Thanks, everybody, for your comments in the chat. And you got some great support here from people, and they're saying a lot of kudos to you being a great teacher. And I would
thanks.
We've seen that from a lot of people tonight.
Oh, good, good. So do what I say, not what, no, what I say. Do, how do you say that? Do what you do and not what I say. Don't listen to what I say. Just always double check those codes I'm throwing at you.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. go to www.codingcertification.org.